Now this model kit review is of the Porsche 356. It's the Carrera 2 hardtop, and it's a 1:24 scale model by Fujimi. Here are the dimensions of the real car details. I got some pictures of the real car as well. Don't like that green. So look at the rest of the box here. Some details there. Let's have a look inside. This is an older kit. Hunted around for a long time to get one of these Porsche kits. And we've got lots and lots of parts to go through here. There's a lot of body parts there. So this is interesting here. They show you all the different Porsches over the years. That's actually really, really cool. And these are the different models that they offer, I guess. Okay, let's have a look. It'd be really hard to find one of these Porsche models. Now here's our body, and fairly well molded. We do have some heavy mold lines here, but those can be sanded off. Otherwise, lots of nice little details. And this part will be removed. Yeah, here are our decals, nicely printed, still in reasonably good condition. Here we have some little pieces, not sure what those parts are for. Looks like possibly some engine parts and hoses. Here we have our wheels. Now these look like really nice tires that are mounted already on the wheels. Those are original Porsche wheels. Here's some other options here. And then little hubs that'll go on. It also looks like we have some mesh there. And that's actually made out of metal. That's not plastic. Yeah, that looks good. Here's our glass. So we've got our windshield here. And side mirrors. Lots of other little glass pieces, including headlights. So let's have a look at those when we're ready to. Yeah. Open this up here, and here, this must be the insides of the door panels, and another part here, not sure what that part's for just yet, and here we have, looks like probably our fuel tank, lots and lots of little bits here and there. This is our dashboard. It looks like some flashing here. Interesting, some mold lines. So not all that well molded. Most of it seems pretty good. And other parts for within the body. Probably engine bay parts. Here is our other dashboard here. With the glove compartment, this is the other side of the engine firewall. And then over here, we have our main chassis frame parts here, fairly well molded. Here's the underside of the chassis, the floor pan. Got lots and lots of body parts all over the place here. Some hood hinges. More hinges here. License plate. Now this is the tail with the rear window. Looks like this is part of the hard top, so you end up painting this part and leaving this part unpainted. Have a look here. So here we have our hood, nicely molded, bumpers, and rear engine cover. We have our seats with some flashing, some mold lines there. passenger seats, lots of little engine parts. Here's our suspension, axles, steering linkage, and then rear seats. Here we have our, looks like our brakes. There's the wheel hubs here. Here are the brakes, actually. Interesting different parts here. Not sure what all these are for. And lots and lots of little details here. So it looks like this is part of the transmission. We have to build the transmission. And that means that this last part here looks like this is the engine. And what's fascinating about this is looks like we even have a crankshaft. Normally you don't even see that stuff. This is all buried in the engine. Here's the engine compartment, the crank casing, some pulleys. I've got a lot of detail here. This is really an exceptional level of detail. And we're not even done yet with all these parts. So let's have a look. This must be our exhaust. All engine parts here, the fan. Lots and lots of detail here. This is an amazing model. So here are our chrome parts. Unfortunately, they're all going to have to be stripped down. Number one is I don't like this type of chrome. Number two is the way they're molded. The chrome has to be painted anyway. But look here, there's some door handles. It's right on the part that's going to be noticeable. You're going to have to cut that part off right there. You're going to have this little white or gray spot where the plastic shows through. This is actually all parts. So that's fine, that was kind of expected. Let's have a look here at our instructions. So some details about the car. We really are gonna have a lot of parts to go through here. So first of all here, these are all the colors needed. That's a lot of colors. So we're going to start off here. So you can build different types depending on what you want. This is the C type, and we're going to start off with the chassis, and then our seats are built. Lots of parts going here to the chassis. That is an incredible amount of detail you're going to be building up there. Building our suspension and steering rack. Lots and lots of detail there. Next, the seats go in. And the firewall, dashboard, front compartment. Lots and lots of details. It's incredible the level of detail here. A number of parts you need to put together. You can do the B type or the C type. Again, down there, we're going to put in our wheel hubs on. Next, we're going to put together the engine. I'm not sure the purpose of painting the crankshaft, because you're not going to see it. And engine is then built. Then the fans put on. Exhaust system's built. And that's all mounted. Looks like this is our flywheel here. And there you go, you can put it on the engine stand if you wanted to. And yeah, the option is to mount it all. Transmission is mounted. And that's all then put into the car, which is rear suspension, as well as the wheel hubs and brakes. Hoods are put on, both the front and the back. Engine cover there, bumpers are put on. It's all then mounted with the glass into the inside of the body. And next, the remaining body pieces are put together. And wheels are put on, and then all the extra little details. So, all in all, a tremendous amount of detail. Lastly, here are the paint and decal guide. These are the different paint colors and then a parts listing. And back here, it shows you how to cut the tapes so that you can paint the rear hard shell.